So we are making a big change in what we're setting right today. You probably have, I know you have already worked on some of these ideas a little bit in DL. They basically come under the field of mechanics. Now, mechanics includes energy conservation and includes mechanical energies. So kinetic energy and potential energies are things that you've talked about in 7A. So you've taken one step kind of into mechanics, and the rest of this quarter will be devoted to taking a couple of other steps into mechanics, or maybe even three. So the first thing I wanted to point out is that there's a big change comes with another change, and that is that the physical quantities that we talk about, and they're names that you use a lot, like velocity, and probably even momentum, and maybe even position. I don't know if you ever talk about positions of things. Those kinds of physical quantities can't be described by giving one number. I can't tell you my location by giving you one number. I need to give you three numbers, it turns out. Three numbers determine locations in space. I can use one word, but if we wanted to talk about numbers, then I could say I'm 10 feet west of that table and 3 feet north of this blackboard, and my feet are connected to the ground. So I've placed myself left and right, forward and backward, and up and down. Because we live in a three-dimensional world, it takes three numbers to tell someone about my position. We are going to work with those three numbers in a really specific way. We're going to draw a vector it'll almost always be a two-dimensional space because I can't draw three dimensions, but the three-dimensional piece is still there, even though it looks two-dimensional. And that vector again, pardon me. That vector is for object A. Now, I've drawn that vector without telling you anything about how I'm going to name those three numbers. And the way I'm going to name them is I'm going to put coordinate axes on this. I'm going to start the position vector at the origin. Other vectors don't have anything to do with the origin. The origin is y equals 0, x equals 0, and z equals 0. The origin in space is what I mean usually when I say origin. It doesn't mean origin in time. It doesn't mean t equals 0. I'm going to call that t initial, or not even call it t equals 0, but just call it t initial. So all sorts of physical quantities are describable in terms of these kinds of arrows. I draw an arrow, and it really means what r really is there's an x component, a y component, and a z component. Fortunately, for position vector, those are just x, y, and z, the coordinates. So if I said I'm 10 feet to the west of that table, then I'm telling you something about where I am compared to this table. So I'm using this table as an origin, basically. I'm 10 feet to the west of it. I'm 3 feet from the board means the origin is not just at this table, but it's at the board, and my feet are standing on the ground. I really chose an origin point right there, on the ground, at the blackboard, even with the table. My coordinate system would be maybe x this way, y that way, and z upward. It would be a reasonable coordinate system. Usually, because we draw two dimensions, I'm just going to do the standard x and y, with y being the vertical axis. Let me make it easier to read. It's the three components of R. If I want to tell you what my position is, I have to tell you my distance from the origin west, my distance from the origin north. So here's the origin right here. My distance west, my distance north, north, and my distance up and down. So I'm going to say my feet are in contact with the ground. So x, y, and z is, in that case, is the location of my feet. They're over here 10 feet, they're 3 feet forward, and they're right in contact with the ground. So you can see a problem already. The location of my feet is not all that close to the location of my hands. Not only that, my feet are just standing there, not moving at all, and my hands are doing all this all the time. So you can tell this is a really, to say that there's a position vector for some object is a real massive simplification. There isn't one position vector for any object. Every object has pieces of it in different locations. We will get to that kind of a problem later. Right now, I'm just going to say, we're going to take every object that we identify by a position vector, we are going to consider it to be a point object. That's our model right now. The model is the way we deal with velocities and momentum and forces is we treat everything as a point. And you know that things aren't points. You know that there are issues that are going to come up later, and we will get to them when they come up. If you don't know what point to take, a point in the object that is essentially always good, if you're really worried about what point to take, a point that's almost always good is what's called the center of mass. So the center of mass for me is probably, I don't know, about this high and somewhere in the middle and somewhere in the middle. So that's the point that that you can almost all, you can essentially always take as a reasonable location of me.